Yes, I'm in a beautiful exhibition. I've been invited here by Bobby Bicker. And we are looking at some PBO art. This is from Georgina Stinson. And she's been using buttons. Look how pretty that is. That's amazing. So you have different techniques used in the same painting, and that's why it's called mixed media. To keep this short, I'm going to show you just my favorite ones. This is quite nice as well. It's called Orbital Luminescence, and it's from Paula Snow. This is quite interesting as well. Karen Pendry. But one of the top favorites so far. Yep, not that. Not that, although it's quite interesting. Is this one. Subconscious Moon. It's brilliant. I don't know how much you can see from this video, but it's really, really well done. So PBO is a very thick type of paint that is actually an alive paint. So it gets into reaction with a different color and creates this wonderful shape that is nearly impossible to create them by yourself. So as the paint dries, it creates even further shapes. So it's basically an alive paint, and it takes a couple of hours to dry, probably more depending on the color. So yeah, it's a great, great technique. Again, mixed media. Well done, Gemma. This is indeed a gem. So let's see some other ones. Sorry. Here is the autumn, and it, indeed, as soon as you see it, it does look like autumn. And it's very, very cute. We're gonna come closer to see the technique. So you see this shininess, it's typical of the PBO type of paint. When it dries out, it has that shininess, same as the gloss. This is also quite interesting. And both Phil and I really love the title, which is The Future is Bright. Some fish creature. I really like the combination of so here we have two men, here we have two women, here we have men and women. So yeah, it's the world nowadays, respecting all genders. I thought that was brilliant. Here is one of my favorite paintings of this exhibition, and we will soon go closer to it. I love the expression on her face, and it's called Ethereal Eidolon by Claire Allen Brun. Let's see if you can read that. Oh, there you go. This one, not everyone likes it, but I find it's, oh, sorry. Oh. There we go. That's better. So this one is like a, well, they call it dead nature. Well, it looks like nothing is alive in there. But what I love about it is that there's still hope. There's still a source of light somewhere. Even though it's pitch black, it's dark, and it looks like there is no creature alive, but there is still hope. This one has been one of the favorites of the jury, and I completely agree. It is indeed stunning. It's beautiful. The use of the colors, it's just amazing. And that is Gary Evans. Well done, Gary. Eccentric lady, indeed, it does look like an eccentric lady. Beautiful, stunning. This one, it's called Texas Tea. And the gentleman that has painted this one, which is called Alan Moo, has actually used petrol. So he's used petrol to paint this painting and then put the petrol on fire. And that's how you get this shape and paint it on top of it. So he actually even burnt his shoe a couple of times in order to make this painting alive. Look, it's beautiful. It's amazing. Not a great fan of this, sorry.
Maybe you went there because I drink something.
So now we're going to go upstairs.
There is more to it.